What is rabies? Is it exactly like what we see in the movies? In short, the answer is no, not exactly. It is transmitted to humans through accidental animal bites or scratches. It is a devastating, degenerative infection that will inevitably get worse over time. However, you can ease your mind, as we do have preventative medical methods that work very well when administered in time. Let's begin by having a look at the makeup of the rabies virus. Viruses are made up of RNA. Just like you and I have DNA, RNA is the virus's instruction manual for proteins that it has to make in order to survive inside of our cells. These proteins help the rabies virus spread even further and hijack more cells. When you think about the small and simple structure of the rabies virus, it is remarkable that it can exert the aggressive and grueling symptoms that we see in rabies. So how exactly does rabies spread between people and animals? Well, the rabies virus is mainly transmitted through saliva of infected animals, such as dogs, raccoons, and bats. When the infected animal bites another animal or a human, the rabies virus enters the body through the wound. The period before the rabies virus spreads to the peripheral nerves is called the incubation period, which may last for weeks. During this phase, no symptoms manifest since the virus is localized to the site of injury. As the virus moves throughout the body, it replicates and visible symptoms begin to appear. Some of the symptoms in humans include physical pain, fatigue, fever, and agitation. Although the rabies virus affects many parts of the body, its major target is the nervous system. The nervous system is made up of the central nervous system, which includes the brain and the spinal cord, and the peripheral nervous system, which includes all of the other nerves in the body. The replicating rabies virus first invades the peripheral nervous system, where it travels through the neurons until it reaches the central nervous system. After reaching the central nervous system, the virus travels up the spinal cord and into the brain, where it rapidly multiplies. The brain is where the virus exerts its detrimental neurobiological effects. The major effect of the rabies virus on the brain involves inflammation. To put that into sciencey terms, it's called encephalitis. Encephalon means brain, and itis means inflammation. So how does this present in people infected with rabies? The brain is the main command center for our entire body. It controls important functions such as digestion, breathing, speaking, and emotions. When rabies takes over the emotional control areas, the patient may feel aggression and anger erratically. Using methods such as magnetic resonance imaging, or MRI, which can scan your brain activity, researchers can identify the specific brain regions that are affected once a person acquires the rabies infection. Current research has shown that brain areas such as the brainstem, hypothalamus, and pituitary gland may be most affected by rabies infections. This may explain the aggressive behavior found in rabies, but again, keep in mind that this information is not fully understood. Although rabies infections can generally be fatal, if patients seek medical help immediately upon being bitten by a rabid animal, the chances of survival increases to 100%. Since the inoculation phase happens before the spread of rabies to the nervous system, there is enough time for a vaccination to boost the immune response to the virus, preventing it from spreading by killing the virus. The post-exposure treatment involves a shot containing immunoglobulins against the rabies virus and a series of vaccinations over the next 2 weeks. These vaccines can be administered both to animals and humans to reduce the spread of viral infection. Workers in rabies-prone environments are recommended to vaccinate themselves regularly, such as zookeepers and vets. Hopefully, you now understand what the rabies virus is, how it acts on the nervous system to cause its symptoms, and how vaccines can be used to prevent it. Although rabies is a frightening disease, we do have countermeasures to prevent it. So remember, always seek immediate medical help when you get bitten by an animal.